And it's almost disrespectful to say it, but there's something about the 83 White Sox.
The assemblage of talent here in Chicago, you know, matches any team that I've ever played on.
And Lamar Horn picks up his 20th victory of the season.
It was very special. I mean, I never had that feeling again. I was fortunate enough to play in the World Series in 1990 with Oakland A's, but when we won in 83, it was very special.
This scores 2-0 White Sox.
And good catch by Debzinski.
Jerry Reinsdorf and Eddie Einhorn bought the ball club. First move they made was to sign Carlton Fisk as a free agent, and then the negotiations took about 3 or 4 weeks, and a couple of weeks into spring training, finally got him signed.
The signing of Carlton Fisk changed the attitude of Chicago towards the White Sox. I mean, this team was the Rodney Dangerfield of baseball. It got no respect. And when a player of Carlton Fisk's caliber decided he was going to come to the White Sox, it sent a message to people that we were for real and we really wanted to win, and it was the dawning of a new era. And Carlton Fisk turned out to be that rare kind of player who plays hard because of pride. And he really and truly, more than any player I think that we've had here, is the symbol of what we tried to do, the symbol of a new era.
That was a key component of our club for years to come. Literally, we realized that Pudge would play that long, 12 years here in Chicago after coming from the Boston Red Sox. And then the signing, the purchase of the contract to Greg Luzinski within the week after Fisk had signed, that added a great stature to our club. And it showed our fans also that our new owners were very willing to go out and try to do the best they possibly can to bring a winner.
It was really something that we're looking forward to, knowing that we had a chance to win right now. And the 81 season, which had the long strike, was the year that we thought we had a chance that year.
It all evolved in 1983. The maturity of some of our young pitchers, Lamar Hoyt, Richard Dotson, Britt Burns, added to the veteran players that we had. We signed Floyd Bannister as a free agent. Ron Kittle came up from Edmonton in the Pacific Coast League. Greg Walker also made the ball club, coming in from AAA. So those were key additions at that time. We had acquired Tom Pachorik the year before from Seattle, and he fit in real well. So we had a blend.
We had speed in the infield. We stole a lot of bases.
We had power, we had defense, real fine pitching, and a great manager and a very fine coaching staff.
And when you have a Hall of Famer catching like Carlton Fisk, you should have a contending team, and we did.